May the Lord add more blessings upon the reading of His Word.
Amen.
This morning I'd like to share with you from the title of your last page in your bulletin. It says there, Rahab Rising. You and I are no different from Rahab. Ikaw po ay hindi malayo sa buhay ni Rahab. You and I all have a past. Ikaw at ako ay mayroong kahapon. At ang ating kahapon ay hindi laging maganda.
Amen.
Kadalasan ang ating kahapon ay pangit.
Yes.
Kadalasan ang ating kahapon ay hindi maganda.
Yes.
Ngunit katulad ni Rahab, ikaw at ako ay umagang ito ay magkakaroon ng panibagong buhay. And that is the reason I titled the message, Rahab Rising. I want you to become a new Rahab of our century. I want you to become a brand new Rahab this year. Because God is able to make you different from the way you were before. Ang Diyos ay mabuti. Binabalik niya at binabago niya ang ating buhay para lamang sa kanyang kaluwalhatian. Ngayon yung bagay nito ay tutumayan natin ang pananampalataya na mayroon si Rahab. Sabi po sa Hebrews 11:31, by faith, the prostitute Rahab, because she welcomed the spies, was not killed with those who are disobedient. Sa mga katagang ito ay sabi po na may akda ng aklat na Hebrews, he made a difference between a person of faith and a person of disobedience. Makikita po natin ang pagkakaiba ng isang tao na mayroong pananampalataya at ang mga tao na hindi sumusunod. Ang sabi po ng Hebrews 11:31, si Rahab daw, at lagi siyang lagi, pag nababanggit si Rahab, ay nababanggit ang kanyang kahapon. Na-identify siya palagi na si Rahab the prostitute. Sapagkat nung unang panahon, wala pong mga apelyedo ang tao. Akala ninyo, ang apelyedo ni Jesus ay Christ, hindi po. Ang ibig kong sabihin ng Jesus Christ is Jesus the Savior. Ang ibig sabihin po ng Christ ay Messiah. That is not the surname of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus Christ is known as Jesus of Nazareth. Sinong Jesus ang binabanggit mo? Si Jesus na taga Nazareth. Nung unang panahon, ikaw ay, you are going to be distinguished by the name where you have come from or kung sino ang tatay mo. Katulad ng James and John, the son of Alphaeus. At pagka tinawag ng Rahab, napakarami pong babae nung unang panahon na ang pangalan ay Rahab. At itinatanong nila, sinong Rahab ang binabanggit mo? Ang Rahab na yun ang dating prostitute. Alam niyo, how low can you go? How low have you been in life before? How low have we been before the Lord Jesus found us? And yet today, I can assure you that your life has been changed. And God has lifted you up from the miry clay.
Yes.
God has lifted you up from where you have been.
Yes.
And you are going to rise.
Yes.
So today, the title of this message is Rahab Rising. I am going to call for from this congregation a brand new Rahab. A Rahab of a new generation. You see, sabi po ni James, lagi pong nababanggit si Rahab sa New Testament. Sabi po ni James, in James chapter 2, verse 25, you see, a person is justified by what he does and not by faith alone.
Yes.
Ang isang tao raw ay itinutwid, pinapawalang sala, hindi lamang ng dahil sa kanyang pananampalataya. In the same way, it was not Rahab, the prostitute. Here he comes again. Considered righteous for what she did when she gave lodging to the spies and sent them on a different direction. As the body is without the spirit is dead, sabi na may akda nito si Apostol James, si Santiago, sabi niya, ang katawan daw na walang espiritu ay patay, ganun din ang pananampalataya. Kung hindi nakikita sa gawa, yun daw ay patay. This year, I want you to manifest your faith by your works. This faith, I am calling for an evidence of your faith. Ako ay tumatawag sa inyo ngayong umagang ito na magkaroon ng kilos, magkaroon ng evidence, magkaroon ng manifestation ng pananampalataya niyon sa buhay mo. I want to see that you are going to produce fruit from your faith. And so I call you Rahab Rising. I want to see you rise. I want to see you be a different person this year. I don't want to only see you as a man and a woman of faith. I want to see you as a man and a woman of action. I want to see fruit of your labor.
Amen.
I want to see that your faith is active. I want to see that you are going to do wonderful things for the glory of God.
Amen.
And so today, here is Rahab. There are five qualities I want you to take from her this morning. Si Rahab po ay may limang katangian na nais kong ipahayag sa inyo ngayong araw na ito. You see, faith is obedience. It is the only kind that saves. And the problem is that you and I have to take risk in order to obey. Sabi po ng salita sa verse 4 to 7, but the woman had taken the two men and hidden them. And she said, yes, the men came to me, but I did not know where they came from. At dusk, when it was time to close the city gates, the men left. I don't know which way they went. Go after them quickly. You may catch up with them. But she had taken them up to the roof and hidden them under the stalks of flax she had laid out on the roof. My friends, in order to become Rahab of this generation, you must be a risk taker. You see, faith always involves risk. At kunayan, sabi po ni Hudson Taylor, a great man of faith who founded the China Inland Missions, always integrated faith and risk. Sabi niya, unless maliban na there is an element of risk in our exploits for God, there is no need for faith. Maliban daw na ikaw ay mag-take ng risk, wala kang pananampalataya. You see, ano ang risk na kinuha or ginawa ni Rahab? Alam niyo si Rahab ay isang prostitute na matali siya doon sa wall ng Jericho. Nung unang panahon, ang wall ng syudad, bawat syudad ay mayroong wall. It is a symbol of their protection. It is their security. At sa ibabaw ng wall na iyon ay napakalapad. Ayon sa isang pamintrista, dalawang chariot ang pwedeng magsabay sa ibabaw noon. And so there are houses there. And one of the houses belongs to Rahab. It must be a tower. Yun ay doon na nagpupunta ang mga tao and to enjoy themselves. And Rahab himself was a woman that is of a low degree. Wala siyang reputation. And yet, dumating ang pagkakataon na nalalaman niya na ang Israel is going to overcome Jericho. Alam niyo, pagka dumating ang mga problema sa buhay, minsan ay ginagamit ng Panginoon ito upang tayo ay mag-change ng loyalty. Upang tayo ay magbago ng pananap. Upang tayo ay magbago ng desisyon.
Yes.
Kung ikaw ay naririto at ang circumstances mo ay hindi maayos. Hindi maayos ang iyong kalagayan sa iyong employer. Hindi maayos ang iyong pamilya. Hindi maayos ang iyong finances. God is calling you to change loyalties.
Yes.
God is calling you to make a decision.
Yes.
God is calling you to make a firm decision for Him.
Yes.
What risk did Rahab take? Itinago niya yung dalawang espiya ng Israel sa rooftop. Tinabunan niya ng mga dayami. Narinig ng hari ng Jericho na may dumating na dalawang espiya at nagpadala siya ng summon kay Rahab. Itabas mo ang dalawang lalaki niyon. Akalain mo nagsinungaling siya. Ito lang ang sinungaling na pinagpala. Hallelujah. Sabagat siya ay sinungaling alang-alang sa mga tao ng Diyos.
Amen.
Ayaw ko kung meron pinatawag na white lie. But this must be one. And this is the lie that even the New Testament upholds. Sabi niya, by faith, Rahab the prostitute, because he welcomed the spies, was not killed with those who were disobedient. He was even called a disobedient one. What did he obey? He obeyed a conviction. Sinunod niya ang kanyang conviction. Alam niya na hindi na magtatagal, Jericho is going to fall.
Yeah.
Alam mo na hindi magtatagal kung hindi ka magpapalit ng loyalty. Hindi magtatagal, mawawasak ang iyong world, ang iyong your small world before you. Alam mo kung hindi ka magpapalit ng loyalty ngayong araw na ito, na wala kang pag-asa. Alam mo na kung hindi magpapalit ng loyalty mo, ngayong araw na ito, you have no hope. You have no future.
Amen.
You have no joy.
Amen.
There is nothing waiting for you. Not unless you're going to change loyalty.
Amen.
And changing loyalty requires a risk. Si Rahab, alam niya, nasa kalagitnaan siya ng nag-uumpugang bato. Yung kanyang loyalty sa kanyang bayan, siya ay isang taga-Jericho. Kasi kung siya ay matagpuan na ng sisinungaling, maaaring siya ipapatay ng hari. She can be executed. She can be charged with treason. And yet he knows. He knows na it is just a matter of time. And to many of you, it is just a matter of time.
Yeah.
I do not care if you have been with life away for many, many years. But if you have become stagnant in your faith, kung ikaw ay hindi nagpapahayag ng pananampalataya na mayroong evidence, kung ikaw ay narito at tagapakinig ka lamang, kung ikaw ay narito at hindi ka kasama sa gawain ng Panginoon, kung ikaw ay narito at nananatili kang malamig, it is just a matter of time. It is just a matter of time. You are going to fall.
Yes.
You are going to be cast away. Because God is calling a brand new Rahab in our generation.
Hallelujah.
God is calling you to be a woman of action.
Amen.
God is calling you to be a woman of faith.
Hallelujah.
God is calling you to be a woman that is involved. God is calling you to be a woman that will put God first place in your heart.
Amen.
My friends, you see, we are going to take a risk today. Napakarami po nating risk. Number one is peer pressure. Ano po ang ibig sabihin ng peer pressure? Napipressure tayo ng mga kaibigan. Napipressure tayo. Another thing that is a risk is to choose our priorities. If God still is not a priority in your life today, it is just a matter of time. And every time, kapon may nagpalag naman po sa akin. And every time na may nagpapalag sa akin ang katulad ng pagpapalag na yon, my heart cries.
Yes.
And sabi niya sa akin na, hey pastor, hindi mo na ako maatin kasi dumating ang aking kaibigan sa Pilipinas. Kailangan i-meet ko siya ngayon. You see, there is always a risk. There is always a risk. Sino ang pipiliin mo? Ang Panginoon, is it God and His priorities or your priorities? I am sorry, my friend, but you have a choice to make. You have a choice to make. Rahab made his choice. And he became blessed. Rahab made a choice and it is a good one. Rahab made a choice and it is the right one. Rahab made a choice. And he is remembered 2,000, 3,000 years ago until now. Rahab is remembered. Will you be remembered as one who is faithful? Will you be remembered as one who is obedient? Would you be remembered as one who made a difference? I want you to rise.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Another risk that we are going to take is loyalties. Sabi ng Panginoon, if you love me more than your father, then you are not worthy of me. If you love me more than your security, then I am not worthy of you. If you love me more than your children, then I am not worthy of you. My friends, There is no doubt, si Rahab, marami siyang kaibigan sa Jericho. Lalo na mga lalaki. You understand what I'm saying? There is no doubt, napakarami niyang loyalties doon. There is no doubt, napakarami niyang mga, he has had many acquaintances in Jericho. But there is a time, sabi po ng aklat ni Solomon, there is a time to embrace. There is a time to refrain from embracing. There is a time to be loyal to someone. There is a time to be disloyal to someone. There is a time of holding. There is a time of letting go. You have to make a decision. Hallelujah. Rahab. I'm calling you Rahab of this generation. Rise. Rise. Take the risk. See Matthew chapter 13, verse 45 to 46. Ang sabi mo yan, napakarami pong mga parable na katulad nito. Again, the kingdom of God is like a merchant. It is like a businessman looking for pearls. When he found one of great value, he went away and everything he had and bought it. Anong ibig sabihin ng parable ng ito? Katulad na katulad na nangyari kay Rahab. He found the way of salvation. Sabi niya, if I am going to survive, I have to take the risk.
Yes.
If I am going to be alive, I have to take the risk.
Amen.
I have to change my loyalty. My loyalty is no longer going to be with Jericho. My loyalty is going to be with Israel and the God of Israel.
Hallelujah.
My friends, a merchant knight is looking for fine pearls. Siguro nakahanap niya, natagpuan niya sa isang auction. Isang napakalaking pearl of great value. Kalain umuwi siya, ibinenta niya ang lahat ng pera niya para mabili niya itong pearl na ito. Who can compare to Jesus? Who can compare the kingdom of God to anything else? God demands that you sell everything you have and come and follow me, he said.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Are you willing?
Amen.
Are you willing?
Amen.
No, are you willing?
Amen.
Are you really, really willing?
Amen.
You see, there's a risk to get away from comfort. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Isa na nakasana na ayaw natin na komportable.
Yes.
Napakarami po umaalis sabagat naghahanap sila ng komportable church. Kung tunay na church ang hinahanap mo, hindi po komportable ang church. Because it demands so many things of us. Kung naghahanap ka ng church, naupo ka na lamang at makikinig. Kung nangarap ka ng church na maganda ang tugtugan, wala po niyan dito. Kung nangarap ka ng church na laging may pakain after the service, wala na pong kain dito. Mayroon ba yata na iiwan sa mga school group? Kanya lang hindi rin magtatagal yun. Mauubusan din sila ng resources. Maghahanap ka na naman. Kung hinahanap mo ay comfort, this is not the place. But God is calling you to a place. Hallelujah. That God is calling you to a place of sacrifice.
Hallelujah.
God is calling you for a place of commitment.
Amen.
Kung hinahasahan mo sa akin that I will not call you to commit, you are wrong, my friend.
Yes.
Because I am looking for people as Jesus looks on people. Sabi niya, except you lay down everything, take up your cross and follow me, you cannot be my disciple.
Yes.
I am looking for disciples. I am not looking for prima donnas. I am looking for disciples. I am not looking for stars. I am not looking for celebrities. I am not looking for whiners. I am not looking for cities. I am looking for people that will commit themselves to the gospel.
Amen.
At hindi ka magsisisi kapatid, may pangako ang Diyos.
Amen.
Ang pangako ko niya, if you are going to live everything for me, you are going to gain it in this world and in the life to come.
Amen.
Salamat po sa Panginoon na bakit pala iniiwanan mo sa panahon ito at sa panahon darating. My friends, I have never seen one who has committed to the gospel, who has committed to the ministry, na nagsisisi siya sa akin, na nagsabi siya sa akin, Pastor, pinagsisisihan ko na ako ay maging miyembro ng iglesia nito. Hallelujah. No, I haven't heard one. Because God has blessed. God knows how to take care of His own.
Amen.
And God is faithful.
Amen.
Behold the turtle. See? I don't even care if you are a turtle. You know what a turtle is? Pagumba. You know? Meron po nandiyan, sabi niya, behold the turtle. He makes progress only because he sticks his neck out. Kaya tamang na magkakaroon ng progress pagka nilalabas mo ang iyong liig. And that is a figurative speech for someone who takes the risk.
Yes.
Hallelujah. My friends, 30 years ago, I did not know that I'm going to become a pastor anyway. I have high hopes for myself. I was very ambitious. But God called me. And I began to speak my head out. And since then, unto me, I never regret that I followed Him. You will not regret too.
Amen.
Give yourself up. Lay your lives on the altar.
Yes, Lord.
Say to the Lord, yes.
Amen.
I am going to follow You.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I am going to serve You.
Yes,
I am not going to be a listener. I am not going to be just a bench warmer. I am going to be involved in the great work that God has given. That, my friends, is a risk taker. There is a passage in the Bible that is quite hard to understand. And the passage says, from the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God is already suffering violence. And the violent take it by force. Now, when you read that passage, you begin to, your first impression is, it is a negative verse. It is a verse that says, the enemy is pounding on the kingdom of God. No. According to the many commentaries that I have read, because of the context also, the translation or the meaning of this is, since the days of John the Baptist, napakarami ng eager na pumasok sa kaharian ng langit. They are so violent in pressing themselves to go into the kingdom of God. And yet, only the violent take it by force. Siya lang na may tunay na hangarin. Siya lang na may tunay na damdamin. Siya lang na may tunay na init ang pumapasok doon. Yan ang sabi ng Panginoon. At kung ikaw ay malamig ngayon, kapatid, you cannot take a risk. And so today, I call upon you. If you are to be Rahab, if you are going to be Rahab, you must rise. You must rise and take your place in the kingdom of God. This brings us to the second, Rahab rising. The second quality of Rahab is an affirmer. Ano pong ibig sabihin ng affirm? In Tagalog, parang ang ibig sabihin ng affirmer ay nagpapalakas ng loob. Okay, I think that's the closest thing. strengthening oneself to be persuaded. It is to proclaim a guarantee. You see, anong sinabi ni Rehab before the spies lay down for the night? Umakyat siya, binisita niya yung kanyang itinago. Sabi niya, I know the Lord has given this land to you. Wow. Alam mo, it is a sign of resignation. Alam ko na ipinagkaloob na ng Diyos ang bayan ito sa inyo. And the great fear of you was fallen on us. Ang laki ng takot namin sa inyo. So that all who live in this country are melting in fear. Lahat ng narinito ay tunaw na sa takot. Hallelujah, because of you. Why? Because we have heard how the Lord dried up the waters of the Red Sea. Narinig namin kung paano tinuyo ng Diyos ang mapulang dagat when you came out from Egypt. Narinig din namin kung anong ginawa ninyo kay Sihon at kay Og, dalawang hari ng mga Amorites east of the Jordan, whom you completely destroyed. My friends, Rahab says over and over again, we have heard. You see, in the New Testament, faith cometh by hearing.
Amen.
And hearing by the Word of God.
Amen.
You see, when you hear something, it gives you faith.
Hallelujah.
But you see, you have to do something about what you heard. You need to affirm yourself. Narinig ko ang ginawa ng Panginoon sa iyo. Over and over again, somebody comes up here and makes a public testimony. At marami sa inyo ay nagkikinibalikan lamang. Over and over, Sunday after Sunday, you come here. You even go to the altar and shed many tears. But you don't obey. Useless faith. Useless tears. Useless coming. Because God wants you to affirm what you hear.
Amen.
God wants you to validate what you hear.
Amen.
God wants you to take action by what you hear.
Amen.
Don't just be a listener of the word. Do it.
Hallelujah.
Do it.
Amen.
Do it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Every time that God is going to be, they're going to be wary of you.
Amen.
And yung sabi minsan ng Panginoon, every now and then God would say, I am wary of you. Pagod na ako sa iyo. Hallelujah. Napakarami ko ng pagkakataon na pinagkaloob sa iyo, bakit ganyan ka pa rin? Let us not wait when God is wary. You see, Rahab, kailangan niyang ulit yung uniform. Alam niyo, pag gano'ng ulit yung mga bagay-bagay, you relieve. Hallelujah. When you begin to affirm it yourself, totoo nga na ang Diyos ay mabuti. Pag may narinig ka dito at nagpatotoo at sinabi niya, God is so good to me. Sabihin mo rin sa sarili mo, God is good to me also.
Amen.
Kung ano ang ginawa niya sa iyo, gagawin din niya sa akin.
Amen.
Because God is waiting that we are going to affirm ourselves. You and I must be persuaded by the word or no one is going to persuade us at all. What do we affirm? We affirm our convictions. Yan yung affirmation every now and then. Dapat ina-affirm mo yun. Okay? Sapagkat yun ang magpapaalala sa iyo na maging ang matupad ka sa Panginoon. You see, coming to church is not truly knowledge.
Yes.
No. But knowledge is good. Amen. We have to affirm that knowledge.
Amen.
You see, testimonies are good Let us learn from them.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You see, si 2 Timothy, ano yung mga affirmations ng mga apostolic affirmations? One of them is found in 2 Timothy 1:12. Sabi po ni Apostol Pablo kay Timothy, "Timothy, I know whom I have believed." Do you know whom you have believed? Hallelujah. Kilala mo ba ang iyong pinanampalatayanan? Do you know Him? Are you convinced? Are you convinced? Are you convinced? That He is able?
Yes.
Is He able?
Amen.
Hallelujah. You can trust Him. Sabi ni Apostle Pablo, I have entrusted my life to Him on that day. And I know He will be faithful.
Amen.
Si David Brainerd, the great missionary to the American Indians, was on one occasion sharing and witnessing to an Indian chief who was very close to deciding to Christ, but he held back. There was some pause or hesitation. Ayaw mag-commit noong Indian. And talaga naman ganun na lamang ang pagsisikap ni David Brainerd sa kanya. At maya-maya ay kumuha siya ng isang mistik at ginuhitan niya ng bilog ang kalibot ng Indian na yun at sinabi niya, "Decide before you cross this line. It is now or ever. Today is the day of salvation."
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
Today is the day of salvation.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Kapatid, I have to compel you. I have to compel you because we don't have time.
Yes.
Sabi po sa Panginoon, ang Panginoon today, not tomorrow.
Amen.
Hallelujah. In the language of God, there is only one time.
Mm-hmm.
And that time is now.
Mm-hmm.
There is no tomorrow.
Yes.
In heaven, there is no yesterday.
Yes.
In heaven, there is no tomorrow.
Yes.
In heaven, there is only eternity.
Yes.
And that is the reason why He's compelling, God is compelling you through me.
Mm-hmm.
If you have not decided yet, you have to decide now.
Yes.
Hallelujah. My friends, why this passion and urgency? Because Brainerd recognized that at that moment, the chief was close to God. You are closer to God than ever before.
Amen.
Ikaw na nananalig po, despite of your feeling.
Yes.
Okay? Ikaw na hindi pa nagkukupit hanggang ngayon. Was there any time in history you are this close to God than ever before? There was no time. Marami sa inyo ay naririto at sa buong buhay nyo, ngayon lang ay nakapagsimba ng ganito. Wow! You are so close to the kingdom of God than ever before. But close doesn't count. Not unless you are inside.
Amen.
You understand?
Amen.
Hallelujah! Sabi po ni Apostol Pablo kay King Agrippa, "King Agrippa, you believe the prophets, do you?" Sabi niya, "You almost persuaded me to become a Christian." I think that was Festus. And almost. Hallelujah. But almost does not count. Hello?
Amen.
Almost does not count.
Amen.
Not unless you are inside the kingdom, you do not belong.
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
Kung paate natin na lang, so, of course, kung this is your first time, accepted ka. Okay, do not come to yourself. Ang ibig kong sabihin ay yung mga anim na buong kami dito, pasulbot-sulbot lang. Wow! Close doesn't count. You must get in. Nagsisimba ka na lang dahil bakit nandito ka pa. You understand? Bakit ayaw ko mag-involve? Ayaw ko ng commitment. Then you do not belong. You understand? You understand?
Amen!
Hallelujah. So proclaimers, compel them like I do.
Amen.
Compel them like I do.
Amen.
Compel them the way Jesus compels them.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so in compelling, we have one voice. Let us affirm what we have heard.
Amen.
Let us affirm what we have experienced.
Amen.
Let us affirm what we have been exhorted.
Hallelujah.
Let us affirm. Oo nga naman. Kaya naman kadalating sa tip na yun. Oo nga, no? Tagal ko na dito, ganun pa rin ako. Okay? How many of you are blessed with someone here?
Amen!
Now, I want to see your hands. Are you really blessed with someone?
Yes!
It doesn't matter if it is not me. Are you blessed by someone?
Amen!
Kung nakita mo yung tao yun, nabibless ka.
Amen!
Hello?
Amen!
Wow! Paano na para sabihin mo, gusto kong maging katulad niya.
Amen!
Gusto ko na ako rin ang mga tao mabibless sa akin. Kapatid, you are not joining a club.
Amen!
Hallelujah! Hindi ito club na mayroong dues every month, which is called tithing. No, it is not. Hallelujah. This is not a club so that you will just feel good. No. This is a fellowship of the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. We have one master and his name is Jesus. This brings us to the third. The third one is confessor. Say that with me.
Confessor.
Are you a confessor or not? Probably you don't even know the meaning. A confessor is one who avows faith in the face of opposition. An isang confessor, you know, itong word na ito ginagamit ang sa Catholic Church sa tiniram ko. Ano na, para gabihin din natin. Ang isang confessor daw ay isang tao na nagpapayag ng kanyang pananampalataya sa kabila ng mga opposition. Sa kabila ng mga tumutunggali sa kanya. Okay? Are you a confessor? A confessor declares and acknowledges openly his faith and conviction. Sabi na to, when we heard of it, sabi ni Andrea, our hearts melted. Wow. Ilang ulit na niya sinabi dito, melted siya. Okay? Nasubukan mo na bang mag-melt sa presence ng Panginoon?
Amen.
Nasubukan mo na ba na, sabi ng isa sa akin, Pastor, yung mga katagang binabanggit mo ay parang mga alaso na shoot na shoot. Hindi ako yun!
Amen!
You see, if God is not going to point those arrows to you, nothing is going to happen.
Amen!
And what's happening right now, our hearts melted and everyone's courage is failing because of you. Can you imagine, there is a whole city afraid, and yet only one would dare confess that the Lord is God. Can you imagine the whole citizen trembling in fear, and yet not one of them is going to do anything about it, but here is a lady A lady of no reputation. A lady that has been called by God, and he is ready to declare.
Amen.
The Lord your God is God in heaven.
Amen.
And on the earth below.
Hallelujah.
There is no doubt. Mayroon silang Diyos, Diyosan sa Jericho. There is no doubt. Like in the Philippines, meron tayo mga patron saints sa bawat barangay. But you see, when this woman heard that his days are numbered, he begins to say, I am not going to trust my saint. I am not going to trust my God. I am not going to trust my money. I am not going to trust my job. I am not going to trust my employer. I am going to trust you. But it is just a matter of time. There are so many things happening in the world today. There is a new movement of terrorism involving the land. Kaya kung alam mo yung sarili mo, nandun ka. Somewhere in Syria, or in Damascus, or in Iraq, or in the Middle East. Wow. Alam, nandito kaya kasi nasa nyo, hindi darating yan dito sa mga papin sila na mga my friends, do not say it out. It's just a matter of time.
Amen.
You see, I believe before the Lord Jesus Christ comes, there will be persecution.
Amen.
And if you cannot commit today, how can you commit then?
Yeah.
It's just a matter of time. And God is calling a new generation of Rahab who will confess his name.
Amen.
Who will not be ashamed.
Yes.
Who will invite people to come and tell them it is just a matter of time. To some of you, it is just a matter of time before you're going to get terminated. And yes, I am kami dito sa Hong Kong na namawalan. Kung hindi kami mawawalan ng dahil sa termination, ng dahil sa pagpunta sa ibang bansa, o ng dahil sa paglipat ng ibang simbahan.
Opo.
Hallelujah. But it doesn't really matter. The Lord is the Lord of the church.
Amen!
Hallelujah. Sabi sa akin ng isang kapatid, Pastor, baguhin mo ang tenor ng iyong mensahe. And I said, I will not.
Amen.
I will not.
Amen.
Never.
Yeah. Never, never.
Hallelujah. Because I know if you stay, you are the only ones that have really decided to stay.
Hallelujah.
Not because of me,
yes,
but because of the God that I represent.
Yes, Lord.
And his name is Jesus Christ.
Yes.
There is no other.
Amen.
Mayroong isang lalaki, Russian siya. Member siya ng KGB. Alam niyo, pagka member ka ng KGB, parang ang Gestapo sa Germany. Ito yung mga secret agent, Mangalan niya si Stanislav Lutsenko. Bago ka ma-recruit dito, dapat excellent ka, intelligent, you have every the qualities of every person is looking for. And he rose from the rocks. And every time, every now and then, ini-interrogate siya ng KGB kung ang loyalty niya ay nasa Russia pa ba o hindi na. And three times na siya ay ma-interview and ma-promote. But not all over their investigation uncovered one truth. Ito pa lang si Stanislav Lutsenko ay isang Christian. Nandito sa Russia, it is an atheist government. They do not believe in God and they found out na ikaw ay Christiano. Wow! You can be executed. ng mga communism before. He kept his faith so secret that no one but he knew it. Again, marami akong alam ng mga Kristiyano ngayon, katulad ni Stanislav Levchenko. Again, sabi ng isang mananampalataya sa kanyang kapatid, nung magkakakilala sila sa isang function, sabi niya, ako nag-church doon sa church na ito. Sabi niya, doon din ako nag-church, bakit hindi kita nakikita? Kung ikaw ay member ng church sa iyo, bakit hindi ka na kita nakikita? Sabi niya, because I am in the secret service.
The secret service.
Hallelujah. Kapatid, kung ikaw ay Kristiyano, you cannot be in the secret service.
Yeah.
You must be open and public service.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Meron pa rin bang hindi umahate na kanilang cell group? Okay? Huwag mo sabihin sa akin na ikaw ay nasa secret service. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My friends, God does not accept people who are in the secret service. Sabi ng Panginoon ko, ako'y pinakaya mo. Hindi ka kaya kita sa aking amang
nasa
langit. And so, for a while, Stanislav Levchenko was able to dodge every investigation. He kept his faith secret until such time he was so convicted by his faith in God. Nung ipapadala na siya sa Japan for an assignment, Levchenko openly went to a church in Moscow and prayed in the altar. Openly, that time, though he had carefully hidden it before, openly so all could see, though previously he had wanted no one else to see. He decided he could no longer desecrate God's name by hiding his faith in secret. He let God decide whether worship should be honest. And I don't know what happened to his love, Levchenko. And yet, this is the only way. Your employer should know you are a Christian.
Okay.
Your mom and dad should know you are born again.
Amen.
Your friends should know that you are born again.
Amen.
You cannot be a salamander. Alam niyo yung salamander? Nagbabago ng kulay. Paglabas dito. Okay, iba na. Sa church, banal. Sa central, hangal. Sa church, ang ganda ng suot. Hallelujah. Please. You are desecrating the name of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Minsan ako'y gulat na gulat. Nakakita ka dito, parang ang Maria Clara. Maya-maya sa Facebook, pinuksan ko pa kasi. Wow. You are completely transformed. Ilang ulit na nga ba sinasabi sa inyo, quit posting pet pictures that are suggested.
Yes.
Kung sabi sa iya pa, ayaw, pagpa-picture tayo, may dalag come here. Pagalugin natin. Huwag kang magpakuhaan ng larawan na nagsasabi, come here.
Amen! Amen!
Huwag mo ipakita kayong singit sa akin.
Nakakahiya.
So, Friends, this is not a laughing matter.
Amen.
It is not. Can you see me laughing now? My heart cries for you. My heart cries for you. It says here, if you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead,
amen,
you will be saved.
Amen.
For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, but it is with your mouth, I'll say this again, it is with your mouth. I'll say this again. It is with your mouth.
Amen.
Open that mouth.
Amen, Lord.
That you profess your faith and are saved. Amen. There was a time early in my ministry na ako tawagin ako pastor. The early years of my ministry, pinalit ako ang pangalan ko. Hindi ako pastor. Ako ay motivational speaker. But you cannot di ka maaaring magpakinggap sa habang panahon.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Today, every time I meet a person in the airport, I always shout, "Ma, kapatid, ako ay born again pastor."
Amen.
And I am inviting you in my church.
Amen.
My friends, open your mouth. You want to be Rahab? You want to rise in faith like Rahab?
Amen.
You cannot be a silent Christian. You must tell. Hello?
Amen.
You must tell. Alam mo, born again ako. Yun na lang ang opening statement mo.
Binago ko na pa.
Hallelujah. And suddenly, a cloud of questions is going to come. Sabi sa akin, anong klaseng born again ka, pastor? Ah, sabi ko, may klase ba? May ibang klase ba? Hallelujah. Ang alam ko sa born again, they believe that Jesus is Lord.
Yeah.
Ah, J.A.L. ka? Hindi! Hallelujah. Hindi, amin ako J.A.L. Pero magkaibigan kami ng J.I.M.
Amen.
Yung isang Diyos ang aming sinasamba.
Amen.
You see, just by calling yourself born again, it opens up a flood of questions. Hallelujah. You see, it is either you are a confessor or a secret Christian, and there is no such thing. Nicodemus was a great example of a secret Christian. But not for long.
Yes.
Not for long. Kinaiiyan niya ang Panginoon. But nandun yung conviction niya. And that's the reason why he came to Jesus in the night. Para walang makaalam. Okay? And so, kumatok siya sa Panginoon at he went there and talked to God, and God said to him, the Lord said to him, alam mo, Nicodemus, not unless you're going to be born again, you cannot enter into the kingdom of God. I don't know kung na-born again siya nung gabi niya mo, no, hindi. And alam, malalaman namin after 3.5 years, nung inando na at kinaakusahan ng Panginoon, isa siya sa mga Pharisee na nag-came out and said, siguro hindi maayos ang gagawin natin kung sisindan siya natin ang taong ito na walang due process. O lumalabas na siya. Hindi niya pinakahayag na siya ay follower ni Jesus. Hinintay pa niya na mamatay ang Panginoon. Nung namatay na ang Panginoon at pinaba siya sa cross, isa siya kasama ni Joseph na nagliling sa Panginoon. My friends, whether you like it or not, you have to declare that you are a follower of Jesus.
Amen.
Kanino ka follower? I don't want you to be a follower of life way, no. I don't want you to be a follower of me.
Amen.
I want you to be a follower of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He only deserves to be a follower.
Amen.
This brings us to number 4. You still with me?
Amen.
Ikaapat na katangian ng Rahab sa ating panahon. Rahab is a redeemer. Di ba't isa lang ang redeemer natin, si Jesus lang? Yes, I know. But you see, when you embrace the redeemer, you yourself become a redeemer. Ibig sabihin ng redeemer, tagapawi, tagatubos. Tingnan ninyo. Now then, sabi ni Rahab dun sa dalawang spies, swear to me, sumumpa kayo sa akin by the Lord that you will show kindness to my family. Wow! Sa panahon ito, isa lang nasa isip ni Rahab ang kanyang pamilya. Sino lagi ang nasa isip mo sa habang nandito ka sa Hong Kong? O ikaw ay may asawa at may anak, lagi mong naiisip ang iyong anak. Lagi mong naiisip ang iyong pamilya. Every now and then sa Facebook, nakikita ko, nagpa-post ka, I wish I am home! Hallelujah! Sabi niya, because I have shown kindness to you, give me a sure sign that you will spare the lives of my father and my mother and my brothers and my sisters and all who belong to them. At lahat ng kanilang pamilya, ililigtas nyo that you will save us from death. Hindi niya binanggit ang kanyang pamilya. Siguro wala po siyang anak. Ay, prostitute nga eh. Hallelujah. And yet, isa lang ang concern niya. See? Even prostitutes love their family. I care for my own. I care for those who love me. I care for my very own flesh and blood.
Yes.
Alam mo ang sabi ng dalawang spies? Hallelujah. You, we swear your blood on our head. But let me ask you to swear also that you will call your family in your house. Gather all your relatives inside his house. Pag mayroon kang isang relative na wala sa pamamahay mo, their blood is no longer going to be on our head. You see, my friends, the promise in the Old Testament is the same in the New Testament.
Yes.
If you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, you are going to be saved. You and your family.
Hallelujah.
You are a redeemer. Nandahin sa pananampalataya mo ay magpapalain ang iyong pamilya.
Amen.
Because God doesn't want you to be bereaved. Hallelujah. Yung mga kapatay lamang po ng nanay ni Sister Gloria. Sister Glo. Bago naman tayong nanay niya, nag-umuwi siya doon, naka-alisa ng taon siya. Naka-alisa ng buwan, wala. And during those months, probably was not trained how to lead a person to the Lord Jesus Christ. So nangyari, napabalik niya dito, ay, yun ang isa sa mga concern. May tinong nga ang son niya. And sabi niya, tumanggap na ba ang nanay mo sa Panginoon? Ang sabi niya, hindi. And something that I have neglected. Marami sa atin ay katulad ni Glo. Nag-iinangalo na lang yung ating patay o nanay. Hindi pa natin sila malig sa Panginoon. And so, she was alarmed. And so, we have to call pastors. I have to call Pastor Ness. I don't know any pastor in Manila. And Pastor Ness knows a lot of pastors in Manila. And one telephone call, two pastors went to the deathbed to the hospital. Hindi pa naman siya mamamatay ng panahon yun. And lo and behold, pinatanggap sa Panginoon. The Lord is. Okay? Talk about insurance. The Lord is. Pagkatapos siya tumanggap sa Panginoon, in 2 weeks time, she's gone. Hallelujah. Alam niyo, kasi naantay rin ng Panginoon na somebody is going to minister to her. And, dinala na siya ng Panginoon. Kasi ang pangako ng Panginoon is always true.
Amen.
God is going to save you and your family. But you have to do
your part.
Kasi dahil naman tayo nanay niya ngayon, uwi siya sa Pilipinas. Nung unang punta niya doon, talaga naman, she is so distraught. At alam niyo ba, siguro ang pumunto ay parang nagsaklubat siya. Nandahin sa hospital bill, and then dun sa kabagat awa na sa kanyang nanay na hindi halos makahinga. Over and over again, naiknaya ko sa inyo na ang Panginoon ay faithful. Alam niyo ang nangyari sa aking tatay at sa mga magulang namin. Both sides of the family ay napaka they lead a life that is not worthy of God. And yet, before they die, they come to acknowledge that Jesus is Lord. There is no doubt. Magkikita ba kami sa langit? Yes. I believe that with all of my heart in you. And yet, marami sa inyo ay nangong problema sa inyong mga anak. Kapatid, if you are going to be Rhea, ang sabi nung dalawang spies, give us a sign. Nag-iwan ang cord, lubid. Ilagay mo itong lubid na ito sa bintana mo na pinaghugusan mo sa amin. At sasabihin ko kay Joshua na hindi niyo susunugin ang pamamahay na iyon. Na walang mamamatay sa loob ng pamamahay na iyon. My friends, how do you take care of your own? It's that we are so sick worried about our children. We are so sick worried about our families. We are so sick worried about these things. And yet there is only one key. If you are going to decipher God and you are going to be wise like Rahab, God is going to take care of yours.
Amen. Amen.
Friends, our families drain everything out of us.
Yes.
How many of you drain ka sa pamilya? Yung babayaran pa lamang ng mga manono, the incessant demands. Wow, minsan nakakapiyo ng ugat. Amen. Sometimes you care about your brother. You care about your sister. Gusto mo silang tulungan. But you cannot. You cannot be the savior of your brother.
Amen.
You cannot be the savior of your sister.
Amen.
You cannot be the savior of your father. You cannot be the savior of your family. There is only one savior.
Yes.
And his name is Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
You better serve him with joy.
Hallelujah.
You better serve him with all of your heart.
Amen.
You better serve him with all of your strength.
Amen.
Put that strength. Put all that strength and worrying in serving the Lord. The Lord will take care.
Amen.
And then we put all our strength. And that is the deploy of the enemy.
Yes.
He overwhelm kanya ng napakaraming alalangin upang nang sa gayon ay hindi ka makapaglingkod sa kanya. Ang daming niya sigasig. Ito mo, every time you go home, I have this air in my heart. Abot-abot ang manalangin ko sa iyo pagka umuwi ka. Kasi uuwi ka na may kagalakan pagbalik dito para kang namatayan. Hallelujah. It would have been better na hindi ikaw umuwi. You see, do not ever, ever forget that God is a Redeemer.
Amen.
And because God is a Redeemer, you are a Redeemer too.
Amen.
Because God is going to take care of yours if you take care of the things of His.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Nandiyan na, pagaling na employer ng Panginoon. And I never regretted na naging employer ko siya. Hallelujah. Hindi naman ako sumasahaw ng ganong palaki. Kaya lang, napakarami kong extra. Okay, napakarami kong extra sa Panginoon. Such that, I do not envy those who have been materially well off than we are. Because I know they don't have the extra.
Yes.
I do have the extra.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. Sabi ko sa Acts 16:31, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you will be saved.
Amen.
You and your household.
Amen.
This brings us to the last, but not the least. And I like the last best.
Overcomers.
Rahab of this generation is going to be overcomers.
Yes.
Hindi ka defeated, kapatid.
Amen.
Amen. Isip mo lang yun. Magbago ka ng pananaw.
Hallelujah.
God has already called you to be an overcomer.
Amen.
And so, we will jump to chapter 6 of Joshua, in verse 25. But Joshua spared Rahab, the prostitute, with her family and all who belonged to her, because she hid the men. Joshua had sent her spies to Jericho, and she lives among the Israelites to this day. My friends, Rahab the harlot becomes a member of God's family. Bago na ang kanyang citizenship, hindi na siya Rahab of Jericho. He is Rahab of the Commonwealth of Israel. He is no longer Rahab the prostitute. No! Hallelujah. You see, from its significance, hindi kilala, hindi nabalanggit, walang pag-asa, walang Diyos, walang kinabukasan. Ngunit narito siya ngayon, siya si Rahab, kasama ng Commonwealth ng Israel.
Amen.
You know, Ruth. Wala siyang pinag-ibahan kay Ruth. From insignificance to significance. Oh! Sa kasang bagay pa, bago ko makalimutan. Alam niyo ba na ang pangasawa ni Ruth ay si Boaz? Alam natin yun. Alam niyo ba na ang nanay ni Boaz ay si Rahab?
Yes.
My friends. Interesting, isn't it?
Yes.
Interesting, isn't it?
Yes.
That the ancestor of the Lord Jesus Christ is Rahab and Ruth. Alam niyo, mga kapatid, napakalaki na magagawa ng Panginoon sa iyo. He is going to change your destiny.
Yes.
He is going to change the story of your life.
Yes.
He is going to change everything. You are going to be amazed. That God has a plan indeed and a purpose in my life.
Yes.
You are a nobody.
Yes.
You are somebody just because you came to know the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Yes.
Hallelujah. is the promise of God in 1 John chapter 5. 1 John verse 5. But it says, therefore, everyone that is born of God. Are you born of God?
Amen.
Ikaw ba ay pinanganak ng Diyos?
Yes.
Kung ikaw ay pinanganak ng Diyos, you will overcome!
Hallelujah!
Because this is the victory!
Amen.
That has overcome the world!
Amen.
Even the faith!
Yes.
That you hold on to right now.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My friends, God is never found accidentally.
Amen.
Kaya siguro masasabi mo, accidentally lang napadaan ako sa life way, natagpuan ko ang Diyos. Hindi ko pati. Inordain ng Panginoon, nandito pa.
Amen.
God is never accidentally found. Rahab was not accidentally found. He was ordained by God. According to God's plan and purpose, before the foundation of the world, you are here.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'd like to end my message with this. 3 years ago, ewan ko kung dito ko nakatira sa Maynila. Meron na akong isang purok sa Maynila, ang pangalan, Purok Walang Diyos. Bakit kaya nila pinangalan ng Purok Walang Diyos? Siguro dahil ang sabi ng Yakna nito, isang missionary, they name it the place without God because it is the place where squatters live. It is a place where there is no hope. No government services is there. The sewage disposal, no garbage disposal. Crooks, criminals, and the lowest among the lowest live there. It is indeed a community without God. It's one of the highest crime rate in Manila. And then suddenly, the government intervened. They begin to give houses to the poor. They begin to clean it up. And they begin to provide them with basic services. Painted the house. Hallelujah. Dumating ang yung nagbibigay ng libreng bahay. Ginawa nila ng maayos na kalsada. And they named the place with something new. Ang pangalan na ng place na yon, hindi na Purok Walang Diyos. Bagong paraiso. My friends, siguro pakaramdam mo, ikaw ay si Rahab. Ngunit hindi si Rahab ngayon, ngunit si Rahab ng Jericho.
Amen.
But God is able to change your name.
Amen.
You are no longer going to be Rahab the prostitute. You are going to be Rahab, the ancestor of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
You are going to be a Rahab that is going to rise in our generation and will prove that God is the God of Israel, that God is a good God, and His mercy endures
forever.
Shall we all rise, my friends? Sing the song with me, Lord, I come to you. Let my heart be changed.
Thank you.
new Rahab of this century. Nais kong tawagin ang lahat ng makabagong Rahab sa ating panahon. The ones that would say, yes, Pastor, I am going to take my risk with God.
Yes.
I'm not going to be afraid of the consequence.
Yes.
I am going to be Rahab of my generation. God is looking for people that will affirm themselves before the Lord, that will confess His name,
yes,
that will redeem their families, their friends, and their world. God is looking for an overcomer.
Yes.
If you feel the conviction of the Lord this morning, lift up your hands wherever you are. Lift up your hands wherever you are. Kung narinig mo ang tawag ng Panginoon, sabi mo, taas mo ang iyong kamay, sabi mo sa kanya, Lord, here I am. I am your Rahab. I am your Rahab, Lord. I will fill the gap. I will stand, Lord, in the gap with my family. Lord, I will be counted. I will no longer be shy. I am not going to be ashamed. I am not going to be defeated.
Yes,
for the Lord, my God, is a great God.
Amen.
There is no one else.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You that lifted up your hands, come forward, friend. I want you to meet the Lord right here on the altar. Right here on the altar, yes. Yes. As you lift up your hand, feel the presence of the Lord. Feel the mighty presence of the Lord, because the Lord has called you. Because the Lord has called you for a purpose. Because the Lord has called you for a purpose. Oh God, Lord, Lord, let Rahab rise in our midst. Let Rahab rise in the core of your heart. For the Lord has called you. No longer are you going to live in Jericho, because I have destroyed it already. I have destroyed your past. Do not go and live there anymore. I have destroyed the walls of your past. No longer live there. For I, the Lord, has ordained you to live in Jerusalem. For I, the Lord, has ordained you to live in my land. For I, the Lord, have chosen you. And you will declare the praises of me. You will declare the praises of him who has called you from darkness into light. You are no longer the children of darkness. You are the children of light. You are the children of a new generation. You are the children, my children, says the Lord. There is no other God like me. Prove me. And I am going to heal your family. I'm going to heal.
Lord, the Lord of the Lord is his. Declare me among the nations. Declare me with your mighty name. Great King, says the Lord. Says the Lord. Affirm what you have heard. Affirm it. Confess it. And you will be my Redeemer. Hallelujah. Take the risk. Come out from among them. Be separate, says the Lord. And I will come to you. Come out from your friends. Hallelujah. And I will proclaim to you, says the Lord. Hallelujah. And you feel the presence of the Lord with you. Can we carry a little moment? Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. Lord, speak. Speak in the name of the Lord. Thank you.